Hive's modulation system centers on a powerful 12-source matrix, in which an array of modulation sources can be assigned to just about every one of its visible controls and a number of hidden ones. However, while modulation assignments can be made directly from within the matrix, drag and drop of sources to targets is also supported, making the process much quicker. Simply drag the crosshairs icon next to the name of a modulation source to a target parameter to make the assignment, then drag up and down on the orange dot that appears on the latter to set the modulation depth. To delete an assignment, right-click the source's crosshairs or the target parameter and select Remove Modulation. If not already visible, the modulation matrix is revealed by clicking the matrix A or matrix B button. A for modulators 1 to 6, B for modulators 7 to 12. Here, any existing drag and drop assignments can be changed and added to, and completely new assignments made. Each modulator enables a single modulation source to be assigned to one or two targets, with a via source in between. Right-click a source or target slot to bring up its selection menu. You can also drag directly from target slots to modulatable parameters. Set the modulation depth with the bipolar knob to the left. And assign a separate source to modulate the depth in the via menu. The five buttons below each target slot facilitate modification of the modulation signal. Curve remaps the source output to an S wave. Rectify offers full and half wave rectification. Quantize snaps the signal through a series of discrete values, chosen from a menu of options including musical scales and chords. The slew limiter softens transients in the modulation signal. And sample and hold captures the output of the modulation source and holds it every time the secondary source selected in the menu crosses the zero line. Try this one with a pair of LFOs running at different rates. Clicking the downward arrow next to any modulator's title number opens a menu of useful preset modulation routings. To add the current routing to the menu, select Save Mod Matrix Settings. Modulation sources include Hive's LFOs, envelopes, shape sequencer, function generators, and sequencer, as well as the usual lineup of MIDI signals, velocity, expression, mod wheel, etc. Two freely assignable MIDI CCs, called Control A and B, and a trio of special sources, alternate, random, and constant. Alternate jumps from plus 100 to minus 100 and back with each new note. random outputs a random value from minus 100 to plus 100 per note. Constant outputs a fixed plus 100 modulation signal for activating hidden parameters and applying controllable offset through adjustment of modulation depth. Sources that aren't actually part of the Hive interface, i.e. all MIDI messages, alternate, random and constant, are accessed for drag and drop in the View selector bar. Modulation targets comprise the vast majority of visible controls in all of Hive's sections, including the effects, modulation depth knobs in the matrix itself, and several less obvious and even completely hidden ones. For example, point an LFO, envelope or other source at the oscillator, octave or semitone menus for pitch modulation, called tune in the matrix, the phase menu for phase modulation, or the wave menu with pulse selected for pulse width modulation. Then there's the invisible in-scale transpose and various effects and shape sequencer parameters, which can only be assigned in the modulation matrix, not by drag and drop.